Ladies and gentlemen, good day and welcome to the Q2 and H1 FY 2022 earnings conference call of Raju Engineers Limited. This conference call may contain forward-looking statements about the company, which are based on the beliefs, opinions, and expectations of the company as on date of this call. The statements are not the guarantees of future performance and involve risks and uncertainties that are difficult to predict. As a reminder, all participant lines will be in the listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference call, please signal an operator by pressing star then zero on your touchtone phone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I now hand the conference over to Mrs. Khushbu Chandra Kant Doshi, Managing Director from Raju Engineers Limited. Thank you, and over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Rutuja. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Raju Engineers Limited earnings conference call for the second quarter and the first half ended 30th September 2021. I thank you for all taking time out and joining us. I have with me Mr. Utsav Kishore Doshi, our Joint Managing Director, Mr. Sunil Jain, our Executive Director, Mr. Jayantilal Dalawadia, our CFO, Mr. Prakash Daga, Vice President, Finance, and Bridge IR, our investor relations team. We have shared our results and updated presentation with the media release. I hope you all have gone through the same. Before we get into the business and the financial performance of the quarter, I would like to share a brief insight about the company. Today, we are one of the leading plastic extrusion machinery manufacturer in India, with nearly 35 years of excellence in extrusion in the industry. Based in Rajkot, Raju Engineers Limited had made a modest beginning in 1986 and has emerged as an undisputed global player in blown film line, sheet extrusion systems, thermoformers, and extrusion coating and lamination lines. Owing to our focused efforts, the company enjoys a premium market position in this segment. In line with our strategy, we continue to expand our global footprint with focus on market penetration and sustained investments in research and development to support the progress. Being a technology-driven company, product innovations, world-class quality, state-of-the-art workmanship, energy efficiency, and high level of sophistication and automation have become the hallmark of Raju products during all these years, thereby positioning our product on a global platform competing with established world leaders. With representation in many countries across the world and customers in over 70 countries, our exports have multiplied since debuting in the international market in 1990. Our brand reliability and position in the market is further encouraged through a number of strong alliances in the industry, such as with Kohli Industries from India, Meef Machines B.V. from Holland, Balzano & Figli from Italy, and the Wunderpac from India. It is an industry practice to build machine with the client specifications to garner the competitive advantage. However, at Raju, we have always been pioneer of change and innovation by identifying just the right technology and its mix to add value to clients' business. We are being appreciated by our loyalists in this business for the appropriate technology approach to consistently help customers' business with customized solution rather than following the traditional approach. I would like to take you through some of the recent developments of our company and the industry by large. We at Raju ensure safety of all employees during the pandemic, followed by the strict safety culture and COVID-19 protocol. We conducted vaccination drive in all the facilities and have ensured that entire workforce is vaccinated. As we are all aware, the second wave of COVID-19 pandemic adversely impacted our lives and industry. Now the economy is opening up as there is a reduction in the cases overall. Also, a removal of lockdown restrictions is the most of the geographics. Consequently, operations have resumed to full capacity as the restriction were eased in a staggered manner by the authorities. Even in such trying times, Raju has a strong and steady order book that enable us to not only sustain but also grow our sales in this challenging time during the quarter. I am happy to share that recently our company's credit rating was upgraded by ICRA. For long-term borrowing, it was upgraded from ICRA BBB plus and from ICRA BBB plus to ICRA A, and for short-term borrowing, it's now ICRA A2 plus from ICRA A2. Now coming to our financial performance. In the quarter ended 30th September 21, our company achieved net revenue of 37 crore, growing 26.2% year on year. Confidence was high during the quarter and the company witnessed faster lifting of the machines by the clients. This stands true for both domestic and export markets. The EBITDA stood at 5.2 crore in Q2 FY22 against 4.16 crore in the previous corresponding period, increasing of 25% YOY. Profit after tax was rupees 3.35 crore in Q2 FY22 compared to last year rupees 2.36 crore in Q2 FY21. Margin stood at 9%, up by 98 BPS. Basic EPS stood at 0.54 in Q2 FY22 as compared to last year's 0.38. If we talk about the half yearly results, revenue from operations in H1 FY22 is rupees 69 crore as compared to 53.77 crore in last year. So YOY growth we reach up to 30%. The situation in H1 FY21 was usually impacted by the COVID related lockdown that impacted the client confidence as demand for resulting products show a deep dive down. As the situation reversed during the Q2 FY22, we are witnessing a normalization leading to better performance. The export during H1 FY22 stood 41% in terms of value. EBITDA, excluding other income, stood at 7.21 crore in H1 FY22 as against 7.09 crore in H1 FY21, increased of 1.67% YOY. EBITDA margin was at 10.31%, a decrease of 288 BPS YOI, as Q1 FY22 show a very deep impact of second wave of COVID crisis and higher raw material prices and supply chain issues resulting into the pressure on the margin for H1 FY22. Profit after tax was rupees 4.41 crore in H1 FY22 compared to rupees 3.75 crore in H1 FY21. YOY increase of 17.50% and PAT margin was 6.30%. The basic EPS stood as rupees 0.72 in H1 FY22 as compared to last year's 0.61. So this is the basic highlight, financial highlight about the company. Thank you everyone for giving us a patient hearing. And now we can take a question and answer. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on the touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. A reminder to the participants to ask a question, please press star and one. The first question is from the line of Rohan Mehta, an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Good afternoon, everybody, and congrats on a good quarter. I just wanted to ask what the raw material prices, your views on this, since it's been a bit of a pain point for this whole industry in general. where do you see the raw material prices going, and you know, what kind of, at what speed can we expect that these price hikes would be passed on to the end consumer?
Okay. Hi. Good afternoon, Ranji. So yeah, raw material prices has gone up. It ranges from, in some cases, 10%, and it is going up to 40-45% in some of the cases. And of course, the global supply chain has also increased the prices of freight and other infrastructures. So it is going up. And to respond to your question that how fast we can pass on to the clients, because the product is capital goods and the product's lead time is around 6 months. So it is not that easy to pass on the raw material price rise. But right, of course, we are reviewing the price index almost every 2 months, and we are trying to pass on to that. But raw material prices, we cannot pass on immediately as compared to the other freight charges and all, because those are the prices which are not included in the offer and the final contract. Those prices can be, you know, passed on to the clients. But here we can say that we take almost every quarter to pass on the prices to the final buyer.
Fair enough. Yeah. And I just wanted to ask about the new products that might be in pipeline, in case, you know, if there's anything around the woven sack or raffia related sectors. Is there any product development going on in that line, sir, ma'am?
Mr. Jain, would you like to take this question, please?
Good afternoon, Mr. Rohan.
Good afternoon, sir.
See, what is happening is that we launched the what is called an extrusion coating and laminating line 2 years back, and that's a very complex technology. So raffia and paper is a much simpler technology. We've already introduced machines for the raffia industry for extrusion coating and lamination. This is used for bulk packaging. So machines are already with the customer, and we are looking at new orders. And it's a much simpler technology both for the raffia industry and paper coating industry. And raffia industry has seen a boom in the last 2 years. That's the reason why we decided to get into that segment as well.
Okay, sir. And sir, do you see packaging sector demand has also been growing? So is it going to be like a similar growth trajectory in the coming couple of quarters, or what are your views on that, sir?
We see the growth to continue in the next couple of quarters, and definitely till end of next calendar year. But after that, we see it stabilizing, because everything is very volatile today. And this volatility in all aspects will continue. We expect it to continue for the next year, and then we expect it to stabilize. But the growth will definitely continue.
Right. So volatility would be temporary, right, sir? I mean, in specific to local markets?
Yeah, temporary has also become very, very relative and subjective nowadays.
True, sir. Yeah. So, sir, in any other technical collaborations are there on the in the charts? I mean, in planning?
Yes, there are. We are looking at some technologies and partners, but I think it's too early to bring them to the table. As soon as we are closer to what we plan, I think we will talk about it.
Fair enough. So maybe after the current financial year, we might hear about something. Would that be okay to say?
Let's hope.
Okay, surely, sir. And sir, just about exports a little bit, if you could give some color on exports, how much of our revenue in this quarter or the first half came from exports, and which, you know, if there's been any key country or market that has been high growth in this particular time period.
Okay, as Mrs. Doshi had mentioned, in first half, 41% of our top line came from exports. And Africa still continues to be a major market with high potential. And we're exporting to Nigeria, Ghana, Zambia, Ethiopia, Congo, Tanzania. And we, during the first half, we also exported machines to Vietnam and Malaysia.
Okay. And sir, the margins must be slightly better in the exports compared to our domestic sales, right? My guess would be.
You're absolutely right, but then one gets impacted by the sea freight rates and the increase in raw material prices.
Right, sir. But we are still price competitive with our local competitors in those markets, right, sir?
We are, yes.
Okay, sir. And any other, this is of course a very long shot question, but in case beyond plastic extrusion, if any long-term plans or maybe just on the drawing board, if there's anything to think about going beyond plastic extrusion?
I think there is enough to do in plastic extrusion itself. So we would prefer to continue our focus on that.
There's
still a lot more to do in plastic extrusion.
Just one last question, sir. I had current capacity utilization levels, if you could just throw some light on.
Utsav, can you bring it? Can you come in? Utsav, Kushbu?
Yes. Hello.
Hello. Yeah, I just wanted to ask about what the current capacity utilization levels are and what would be ideal, maximum utilization levels.
What we are utilizing as of now, it is nearly 70% of it. And there are still scope of like 10 to 12% more that we can optimize our sources and we can improve the productivity.
Right. So I think, 10 to 12% increase in utilization can be expected in the next 3 to 6 months. Is that right?
Yeah, that's what we are trying, yes.
Okay. So that economies of scale would also benefit the profit margins, right, sir?
Correct.
All right. Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you so much. I'll get back in queue if I have more questions. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Ravi Sundaram from Sundaram Family Investment. Please go ahead.
Hello, madam. Thanks for the opportunity. Sorry, I joined late. I was in another con call. But I missed some opening remarks. I have two questions. First is on the order book and revenue guidance. Generally, the feedback that we analysts are getting from the capital good companies is we are in really a good time at this point in time when it comes to demand. How is it for our company?
Sir, I got one question. Your question was about the order booking, right? And I could
order
not follow the
how
second
is,
question.
I'll repeat. How is the order book, madam, and how is the demand playing out for our company?
Okay. So the current order book, we can say it's 100 plus crore as of now, the pending orders we have on hand. And demand, of course, because of the COVID, the plastic consumption and the packaging need has gone up like anything. So the demand is continued to grow, and we feel that further demand would be created. If you look about the global market, then again, the COVID pandemic has cropped up in some of the territories. So it is further increasing the packaging demand. And in earlier answer, we talked about the raffia industry, which is continued to grow at 20 to 25% rate, which is again we are seeing a good opportunity for the coming quarter.
Okay, madam, one clarification: this 100 crore order book executable over how many months?
It's 6 to 7 months over from today.
Okay. Madam, my next question is on margin profile. One common pattern we are seeing is the input raw material prices have been volatile, and that is impacting companies like yours. How are you finding it, and how should we predict it for the coming quarter?
Prakash Bhai, would you like to take this, please?
Sir, may I repeat? Should I repeat my question?
Prakash Bhai, you there?
Hello.
Yeah.
Sure.
Sir, my question is, generally what we have been observing is raw material prices are impacting companies like yours, particularly most of the raw materials that we consume have been volatile at best. So company, how is it for our company? How should we, pin down the margin number for our calculations for the upcoming quarter?
See, if you compare quarter on quarter, the previous quarter, the raw material cost was a little bit higher. But during the quarter, second quarter, it has come down to 56.68%. And the margins are also slightly improved. And we see further improvement in coming quarters due to the because the new orders what we are executing right now are with the revised prices. Revised price means new prices. So the raw material cost is expected to further improve during the next two quarters. And definitely that will give an impact on margins in terms of improvement.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Madam, amazing execution. All the very best for your future quarters. Thank you.
Thank you. Participants who wishes to ask a question, please press star and one. The next question is from the line of Aniket Redkar, an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Hello. Good morning. Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Yeah.
I have a couple of questions. Sir, my first question is basically related to the financials. As you can see, our revenue increased by 26% year on year. So, what basically the main reason? What drives the growth? I mean, for which particular product you are getting more demand? I mean.
Okay. Good afternoon, Aniket. Addressing to your question, if you compare quarter to quarter, year on year, last year during quarter two, the global economy was just on revival mode with slow recovery from pandemic crisis, resulting in low uptake of machines. Now, during this current year, final second quarter, the lifting picked up owing to increased confidence in the market and lower spread of the pandemic. Higher number of machines were dispatched during this quarter, both domestic and exports. So that has mainly contributed in the increase.
Okay. So related to this, can you give some brief about, as we can see, the raw material price is continuously increasing from last quarter also. And the last quarter we had faced that Khushbu ma'am mentioned that we are getting order in advance. So what is your future plan?
Hello.
Sorry to interrupt. The line of the participant got disconnected. We'll move to the next question, which is from the line of Rohan Mehta, an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Hello. Thanks for the opportunity again. Sir, I just wanted to follow up with some financial questions. Just wanted to know the other income has grown year on year this quarter. So is this what does this mainly come from, the other income?
See, this increase, the increase in other income has been mainly contributed by interest on fixed deposits and forex gain. The other income has increased by approximately 26 lakhs during this quarter two. And it is mainly because, you see, the company is having surplus funds, some surplus funds, which it is parking in fixed deposits. So we are earning interest on that. And it is partly contributed by the foreign exchange gain.
So, sir, would it be similar kind of levels in the coming couple of quarters also, or was this a one-off increase?
See, if you talk about interest on fixed deposit, we can say more or less it may continue. But regarding forex and forex fluctuation, difficult to say anything right now because it only depends on how foreign currency is moving in the international market.
Fair enough. Fair. And, sir, the debt seems to have reduced. So, has it been paid off through internal accruals only, or has been any other source of repayment?
Yeah, the debt has been paid entirely from internal accruals only.
Okay, sir. And sir, the other operating expenses and employee level expenses that have been there, would they also now that you know, compared to last year, of course, sales was affected because of the lockdown. So that's why maybe as a ratio, they've improved. But would they be at the current levels only going forward? So if sales continue to increase, then employee and other expenses would remain at similar levels, right, sir? Or is it safe to assume so?
Yeah, see, the company is having a policy of conducting performance appraisal early increments once in a year, that is July, during July. So that has already been announced. So the whatever employee cost is reported in this quarter, it will remain at the, more or less at the same level.
All right. Understood, sir. So, sir, any guidance on the long term in like maybe 2 to 3 years, some rough guidance on the top line and bottom line? What kind of targets we might be looking at 2 to 3 years down the line?
Ms. Doshi, can you
just... Considering the uncertainty around, we would like to, you know, grow at a 12 to 15% for another 1 year, and over after 2 to 3 years, as we rightly talked about, some of the industry joint venture or a merger, what we are targeting. So with that, probably we would be able to grow at 20% in after a year or so.
Okay, ma'am. So this would be growth in top line, and the EBITDA and PAT level margins would be maintained, right, ma'am?
Yeah, it would be maintained, and it would be slightly improved after this particular after the year time when we have some more product lines in the portfolio which we are targeting now.
Oh, great news, ma'am. So this joint venture you mentioned is the same which sir was mentioning about the technical collaborations that might be...
Correct. So the full, I mean, the format will be anything. It has to be, I mean, it is under process to derive. Probably not the right time to talk further till we finalize something. But yes, that is something in the pipeline.
Fair enough. And ma'am, export market is likely to remain same in terms of the countries that are there currently. Any new countries not likely, right?
No, we are representing in 70 countries, and I think those are the countries which are still under having a good growth potential. Some of them are still under the lockdown, so yeah, struggling with that, but more or less the geographic expansion will remain the same, but the same penetration will be more in the same market.
All right. Understood, ma'am. That makes sense. Just thank you for bearing with me for so many questions. I just had one last question about the land that we had acquired some years back. Is it like any capacities underway over there, or has production expected to start anytime soon over there?
So it is now already we got the paper clear, and it is now non-agriculture land, good to go with the construction and all. So the plans are on the table now, and probably by the next year we would have some capacity enhancement over there.
Okay, so are we looking at any sort of capex for that?
Not in this year, I mean not until the March, but we are in a planning, so probably it will affect after the March.
All right, ma'am. All right, okay. Thank you so much, and thank you for answering my questions, and all the very best, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Aniket Redkar, an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Sorry, everyone. My call was disconnected.
No worries, sir. Please go ahead.
I was talking about the raw material prices. As you can see, it's continuously increasing, and we never know to some extent how much it can increase. So what is our plan for this? I mean, how are you going to manage this raw material price?
I wish I have an answer. Raw material prices are going up, of course. At a certain level, we are planning our forex accordingly, and of course, we are trying hard to pass on to the end customer as well. So, and considering the order levels, we have also changed the procurement style. So these are the few points which are helping us to manage. But of course, we cannot control the raw material pricing, because all the resources, crude is going up, and so it has an effect on everything. So yeah, this is what it is. It's going up, and
side.
So when you're taking the order, you are not fixed the price. I mean, you are intimating before unless and until increasing the raw material price, right?
No. Once we take the order, there is no effect of the prices is given to the customer. So what we do is we keep on changing the index price of the product when the spike comes in the raw material pricing.
Okay.
But once the order taken, we don't go back to the customer and talk about the pricing.
Okay. So as you can see, other income is also increased by 167% YY. In quarter on quarter and also HOH also. So
yeah.
What basically the main reason for it?
Prakash bhai, would you take this?
See, in terms of percentage, the other income shows an increase of 167%. But the increase, if you talk about in absolute numbers, during this quarter, it has been 26 lakhs during the quarter two. And it is mainly contributed by interest on fixed deposits and some forex fluctuation gains.
Okay. Got it. So, sir, tax rate, we can see tax rates also increase by quarter on quarter. So, can you tell me more about it?
Yeah, see, income tax provision in percentage terms seems to be higher in this quarter as compared to corresponding previous quarter. But if you see, it is purely due to this proportionate higher depreciation available on deduction as deduction from profits and gains of business during the corresponding previous quarter.
Okay. Got it. As you can see, can you see a packaging industry, demand for packaging industry for the future, for the next 2 to 3 years? Can you throw some light on the packaging industry overall? What do you see in the coming quarters or for the next 2 to 3 years?
Mr. Jain, would you like to address this question, please?
Yeah, I think your line got disconnected. This question was asked, but anyway, I'm going to repeat it again. We see the demand to continue at the current growth rates, at least in the end of next year. And then we expect it to stabilize.
Okay.
That's the way we are saying it.
Okay.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Hitesh Kumar from Aksa Capital. Please go ahead.
Hi. Thanks for the opportunity. Sir, if in plastic extrusion machinery, if I have to understand, how vast is the product portfolio that you have, and what are the gaps that you are probably looking to fill in this portfolio?
Okay.
Mr. Jain, would you take it?
Yeah. Let me take that question. See, plastic extrusion itself, there are many things in plastic extrusion which we are currently doing, and there are many things which we want to do. For example, there is a product called tarpaulin. It's a cross-linked, cross-laminated film. It is from blown film, which is extrusion. And then there is a post-extrusion process.
Mm-hmm.
So that's something which has been also introduced. And we mentioned about extrusion coating and lamination. That is another corollary coming in from extrusion. So these products itself, then blown film, when we talk about it, blown film itself, it, earlier it used to be monolayer, then it became 3-layer, then it became 5-layer, then it became 7-layer. Now the market is looking at a 9-layer blown film.
Mm-hmm.
So the point I'm trying to say is in extrusion itself, plastic extrusion, there are many technology upgradations which are taking place, which we are trying to focus.
Okay. Any specific technology that you're looking to get into or probably you're looking to build some capabilities towards?
Let me put it slightly differently. The focus now is looking at more and more applications from the same process. Like I mentioned to you about tarpaulin, the same process basically blown film, but it's another application. Then there is another application called geomembrane that is also coming from plastic extrusion, but in a different way. So these are technologies, the process remains the same. The technologies keep on increasing.
Okay, okay. So this will, all these would be an extension to the machineries that you're already supplying to the clients, is it? Which will help them in the further, probably into application or probably further modification to product that is already coming out of the same machinery?
Yes, and trying to cater to different market segments. Packaging is one market segment. Raffia is a part of packaging, but it is a different segment. It's not food packaging. Then you have tarpaulin, which is again coming from the same process, but it's a different market segment.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, in the past, the company used to be more involved in only food packaging, and now we have diversified into different industries like agriculture and infrastructure as well.
Mm-hmm. Sure, sure. So all this is targeted towards your domestic market, or you're also looking at export markets?
Even the export markets.
I see. Okay, got it. Sure, sure. And any major capex that you're looking? Obviously you cannot comment on any inorganic expansion, but any major expansion that you're looking at? I believe sometime back, Ms. Khushbu mentioned about putting a plant at the land which you recently had acquired. Just want to understand what will be the quantum of capex that you will probably look at undertaking, or any cap on the quantum that you are looking at?
Ms. Doshi.
This is the operator. Does that answer your questions, Mr. Hitesh Kumar?
Sure, no worries. I mean, I was trying to understand the quantum of capex that they can probably think of, but I think that's fine if that's your main contention. Thanks.
Hello?
Yes?
I think I missed something.
There was a question asked by Mr. Hitesh Kumar. And
no, I was just trying to understand if at all any expansion that you plan to undertake in the entity. This is an organic expansion. So, what would perhaps be the quantum of capex that you can probably be thinking of? Okay.
For the land which we have bought we are targeting to have something by the next year there, the capex requirement would be for this particular thing would be 100 plus CR. So this is something we have on a drawing board and things are moving accordingly.
Okay, sure, got it, yeah, thanks.
Yeah, thank you. Sorry for this delay. I think I missed something in between. So.
Right, no worries.
Thank you.
Thank you. Participants, to ask a question, please press star and one. As there are no further questions, I would now like to hand the conference over to Mrs. Khushbu Chandrakant Doshi for closing comments.
Yeah, thank you everyone for joining us. And should you have any further questions, you can reach out to Bridge or us directly. Thank you once again for taking time out. Thank you.
Thank you. On behalf of Raju Engineers Limited, that concludes this conference. Thank you for joining us, and you may now disconnect your lines.